Yeah, so good day. We're going to talk about weirs, okay? Under pa rin ang ating fluid flow measurement. So, weirs are overflow structures that are built across an open channel to measure or control the flow of liquids. So, ginagamit pa rin siya. Like with the gates, no? Kung ano man yung concept natin ng gates, the same concept that we have in weirs. So, nya lang, of course, with the application of the calculus and the concept of orifice, no, tubes, ayon. So, same yung ating principle na ginagamit doon. Okay? So, hindi lang water ang ginagamit natin for liquid na ating weirs, no, pwede rin ibang klase ng liquid. Okay, so these are the classification of weirs. We have the rectangular, yung pinaka-common sa lahat, the trapezoidal, okay, the triangular, circular, and parabolic. Okay, so those are the classification of weirs. As we go along with this discussion, mali-discuss ko sa inyo yung iba't ibang classifications. So here is the path line of flow of a rectangular sharp-crested weir. So makikita natin, meron tayong mga iba't ibang parts. So pag-usapan natin. So we have the nape, or which is the overflowing seam in the weir. Ayan. So nakikita nyo ba ito? Ito na yung ating nape. So kapag bago siya, yan. No, bago siya mag bumagsak sa kabilang side, no? Yung itsura niya. Okay, yung crest ng weir, ayan, yun yung ating kung ano man yan, kung sharp crested ba siya, sharp edge, rounded, okay? So, the edge of the top of the surface of the weir in which the flowing liquid comes in contact. So, kaya nagkakaroon ng dalawang klase. We have the contracted and suppressed, no? Ngayon, depende naman yung ating contracted and suppressed weir on the length. Okay? So kapag contracted, no, yung ating sides ng sharp edge orifice or sharp edge ito weir, so that the nape is contracted with in width or having end contraction yung sa dulo, paliliitin. Okay? So nagkakaroon na nga ng contraction because of the what we call drawdown, pero nagkakaroon pa ng what we call contraction in relation do sa kanyang cross sectional area. It's the same thing with full with the weir, or what we call the suppressed weir. Pag suppressed weir, it's having its length being equal to the width of the channel, so that the nape suffers no end contraction. So same, no, the usual rectangular weir, okay, the suppressed or full width weir, okay. So next we have the drop down or draw down, which is the downward curvature of the liquid surface before the weir. Ito yung bago makapunta doon sa kabilang side. And then the head, which is the potential head, no, the distance between the liquid surface and the crest of the weir. So, dito, yung ating head, no, measured din gamit yung ating equation of what we call h sub v, no? Yung ating velocity head na v squared over 2g. Ayan. Kung nakikita nyo doon sa ating illustration. Okay? So, sama-sama na yon. And then, we have this, what we call the total head. Okay? So, these are the parts na meron pa tayong weir plate. Ayan yung plate na nilalagay. So, the channel bed, of course. Then, we have the distance between the crest and the possible na water surface before the drawdown, which is 4H. No, yun yung the usual na ginagamit natin kapag nagko-compute. No, yun ang approach, no, kumbaga yun ang base, no, baseline natin in terms of calculating the possible drawdown, kasi yung slope, kumbaga. Okay, sige, so let's talk about rectangular weirs. Okay, so rectangular weirs, ito yung kanyang illustration. Ayan, so as you could see, yung crest natin, yun yung medyo shaded na part, and then the discharge here na kinocompute natin using the formula 2/3 times C, yung ating coefficient of discharge, square root of 2G times L, multiplied by H, yung malaki, yung H na head, ito, nandito nakikita nyo sa right side, okay? Plus H sub V is yung sinabi ko kanina na velocity head na V squared over 2G. Yan. Okay? Raised to 3 halves minus h sub v raised to 3 halves. Okay. This is actual discharge, no? Kasi meron tayong coefficient. Now, if h sub v, okay, or should I say, yung ating 2/3 c square root of 2g, pwede natin sabihin siya as weir factor. Katulad nung discussion natin ng unsteady flow, ginawa natin ng coefficient of time, no, or factor time, yung ating C sub T. Oh. The same thing with this, no? Para mas mabilis siyang ma-compute. So, maging gito na lang, no? C sub W and then the remaining parts of the equation. Now, if H over P, eto, no? Ano ba yung P? P is the height of the crest, no? If H over P is, sabi dito, is sufficiently small, the velocity approach becomes very small. Kaya yung ating H sub V na raised to 3 halves ay mana-neglect. No? So, ito na lang yung magiging formula natin. Q actually search equal to C sub W L H raised to 3 halves. Okay? That is for the if H sub P ratio is sufficiently small. Now, okay? Ito naman, nakikita nyo yung formula dito is if the situation where the discharge is required considering the velocity approach, yan. So, magkakaroon tayo, yung ating equation na kanina, no, yung unang-una, magkakaroon ng successive trials. Okay? So, lalabas, ganito na lang siya, no, in terms of what we call yung ating depth. So, Q is equal to C sub W L H raised to 3 halves, no? Kasi nga, ito yung, ano na, ito nga ulit, ano ulit, if it is, ano, yung ating equation ay, yung H sub P is very small. Pero, dahil kinoconsider natin yung possible, no? Yung possible na velocity approach, no? At nagkakaroon tayo ng trial and error in solving Q. So, magkakaroon tayo ng factor na tinatawag natin na 1 plus C sub 1 multiplied by H over D raised squared. Okay? Wherein C sub 1 is 3 halves multiplied by C sub W squared over 2G. D is the depth of the water upstream and D is equal to H plus P. Ayan. Kung babalikan natin yung illustration, eto. Okay? Yung D is the depth of the water upstream. Yung total. Okay? So, ayan. No? Kung kinoconsider natin yung possible na paggamit natin ng velocity approach, nagkakaroon tayo ng trial and error sa Q or discharge. Kaya mag-arrive tayo sa ganitong formula. Okay? So, that is for the rectangular wheels. So, under rectangular wheels, we have what we call standard wheels. Okay? Standard wheels are wheels having the following specification that must be applied to, yan, to the standard wheels without end contractions. Okay? So, una, the upstream face of the wheel plate should be vertical and smooth. Yun yung umpisa. Lang smooth, vertical. The crest edge shall be level so that shall have a square upstream corner and shall be narrow that the water will not touch it again after passing the upstream corner. So, the right direction is downstream. Okay? Next, the sides of the flume shall be vertical and smooth and shall extend a short distance downstream past the weir crest. Okay? And then, the pressure under the nave shall be atmospheric. Kaya, ina-assume natin na wala tayong potential energy head, no? Kaya ang consideration lang natin, kinetic energy. The approach channel shall be a uniform cross-section for sufficient distance above the weir or shall be provided with baffles that a normal distribution of velocities exists and the flow approaching the weir and the water surface is free of waves or surges. Walang disturbance. No? Yun yung point dito. Pag-flow dapat siya freely, no? Kung magkakaroon man ng possible disturbance, kailangan i-control. No, lalagyan natin ito natin na baffles no, para mag-normalize yung distribution natin mga velocities. Okay? So, that is for the standard wheels. Now, let's talk about yung CW natin or C sub W. Ito natin na standard wear factors. Ayan. So, ano na nga ba? No? So, meron tayong kanina, no, napag-usapan na natin yun. So, balikan lang natin. So, we have the standard wear factor na equal sa 2/3 C square root of 2G. This is in relation to what we call general approach for rectangular wears. But, if it is a standard rectangular wear, so we have this equation based on Francis formula. So, based upon the experiments on rectangular wears, from 1.07 meters, 3.5 feet, to 5.18 meters, 70 feet long underheads from 180 millimeters to 490 millimeters. Ito yon, no? Gagamit ka ng Francis formula kasi based on sa experiment to eh. So, siguro iteration of data, no? Or pag-close ng data, no? Or yung close related yung ating mga data, ayan yung kinalabasan. Okay? Natin do sa ating formula. So, that is C sub W is equal to 1.84 multiplied by 1 plus 0.26 H over D squared. Okay? So, ayan ay kapag Francis formula. So, ngayon, using that Francis formula, if H sub P is less than 0.4, magiging ganito na lang, no? Mawawala na yung ating multiplier sa 1.84, no? Mangyayari kasi is, magiging sobrang liit, no? Magiging sobrang liit ng ating ratio, less than 0.4. So, pwede palang mag-ganito 0, kung sakasakali man. Okay? Or 0.1 sa maliit na. Kaya lalabas na lang dito is 1.84 for SI, 3.33 for English. Okay? So, ayan na. And then, we have the Rebock and Chow formula. So, sa Rebock and Chow formula, ginagamit natin yung ratio ng H over P. Kapag SI, 1.84 plus 0.22 H over P. Kapag English, 3.27 plus 0.4 H over P. Okay? That is for Rebock and Chow formula. Then we have the Bayesian formula based upon the experiments, no? No ating... Ayan. Sa Bayesian formula, ayan. So, sa Bayesian formula, ito na yung formula natin. So, typo on the first part. Pero ito yung ating formula, no? C sub W 0.5518. Ayan, mahaba. Multiply by 3.248 plus 0.02161 over H. Multiplied by 1 plus 0.55 H over D squared. Okay? That is for Bayesian formula. So, Bayesian formula, ginagamit natin siya for rectangular wheels of length having 0.5 to 2 meters under the heads of 50 mm to 600. So, iba to, no? Yung definition dyan, that is for Francis. So, isin na natin, no, as send to you the soft graphic. Okay? So, that is for the Bayesian formula, standard wheel factor. So, now let's talk about ito na, yung contracted rectangular wheel. Kaya na lang nabanggit na natin na meron siyang tinatawag na end contractions. Okay? So, ano nga ba yung end contractions ito? So, effective length of a contracted wheel. So, effective length dahil nagkaroon tayo tatawag na contraction. Ano yun? Ito yung nasa gilid. No? Ito yung ating contraction yan. Ito. So, one end contraction, ito yon. Ito yung contraction na sinasabi. No? Yan. Ito, yung dalawa yan. Ito, tsaka itong isa. Ayan, contraction din to. Okay? Kapag one end contraction tayo, ito, yung ating n is equal to 1 at 2n, n is equal to 2. Yung effective length natin is L prime minus 0.1 n times the height. Ito, yung ating height. No? May ano yung L prime, L, tsaka n? Nabakita natin yung contraction. H is the height. So, L prime is the measured length of the crest. Okay? Kung ano man yung haba niyan. N is the number of end contraction. H is the measured head. Okay? Sila. Then, from there, balik tayo dun sa formula ng rectangular wheel. Ito. Kung kapag nalaman na natin. And then kung sa mga wheel factors, ito. Yan. Francis formula, the Rebock and Chow, and the Bayesian. Okay? That is for the contracted rectangular wheel. So, nagkakaroon lang tayo ng end contraction. Pag suppressed, sabi wala tayong end contraction. No, buo siya. Buo talaga. Walang kahit na anong sagabal ito. Itong length na to, yan, kung ano man yan, no? Wala yan kapag, say, A, no? Wala yung A length na yan kapag suppressed to you. Okay? Kasi, equal. Okay? So, now let's talk about triangular wheel or what we call V-notch. Okay? So, for a very low heads, a V-notch wheel should be used if measurement accuracy is required. Low heads dahil kailangan bumilis yung ating velocity. No? Siguro mabagal. Okay? Kaya ginagawa rectangular. The vertex angle theta of a V-notch wheel is usually between 10 to 90. Okay. Siyempre, habang lumiliit yung degrees, mas mabilis. Pag lumalaki, medyo mabagal compared to sa mas maliit na degrees. Kasi alam natin na lumiliit din yung kanyang area of exit. Okay? So, ito yung parts ng ating triangular notch. No? So, ito pantay. No? So, meron tayong length. And then, L over 2, we have this x over 2 in kung magkakaroon tayo ng differential height no in terms of the weir no ito yan nakikita natin sa ating illustration. So for the formulas no ang actual research natin for triangular V notch or triangular weir is 4 over 15 c multiplied by square root of 2 gl h raised to 3 half. So kamukha ng ating rectangular, no? Pero dito naging 4 over 15. So, yan. And then, actual discharge, no? Since yung actual discharge natin, kaya naging ganito, no? Sa ating actual discharge, okay? Yan. And so, for actual discharge natin, okay, na naka-SI pa rin, okay, if, no, if ginamita natin ng iba pang formula, pwede rin ito, no, kung yung ating angle, no, lumalabas na hindi siya 90, okay, kasi yung formula kanina, ayan, yung isa na nakikita nyo, is assuming na, ano to, na naka- general equation tayo, no, mukhang 90 degrees ito, no, at some point, no, dahil yung ating height is full height, ayan. So, ito yung ating, tawag dito, equation. Ngayon, kung ating inclination ay unequal, ito yung ating formula. 8 over 15 c square root of 2 g tangent theta over 2 raised l h raised to 5 halves. Okay? So, kapag unequal. So, this formula is dedicated if the side inclination if the side inclination is unequal. Hindi pantay. So, magkukos tayo ng angle. Kung yung ating inclination ay equal, so possible na ito na, no, yung ating formula na nasa taas. Pero kung hindi, ito na sa baba. Okay? So that is for the triangular V-notch. Now, kung standard yung weir natin, no, standard 90 degree weir, ito yung ating discharge, no. Kung galing dito, no, yung 4 over 15, ito na lang siya, 1.4 h raised to 5 halves. Okay? SI and then English 2.5 raised h raised to 5. Standard 90, no? 90 yung length. Okay. So, yan na. And then, let's talk about the trapezoidal sharp-crested weirs. Okay? The trapezoidal sharp-crested weirs, so, meron tayong formula na Q is equal to C, ayan, C sub W sub 1 L h raised to 3 halves at C sub W sub 2 Z h raised to 5 halves. Okay. Yan ang tanong, ano-ano yung mga z na yan at ano-ano yung ating c sub w sub 1. So, depende ito no, sa ating since trapezoidal to, so nagkakaroon tayo ng dalawa. No? We have the angle and then we have the rectangle. So, yung z value natin, ito ko na nalagay, yung ating z, okay, ito, our z value is equal to b over h. Ano yung b? Ito, b times parang ratio, no? Or, yama, ratio or slope, no? Ng ating side slope ng ating trapezoidal weir, okay? So, c sub w 1, no, depende kung ano yung ginamit natin. Okay? Ayan. So, ito yung ating depende sa naging angle. Okay? So, that is for this trapezoidal sharp crested weir. Okay? So, C sub W1, bibigay ito. Or kung hindi man ibigay, kukumpute. no? Yun ang catch dito. Pag hindi siya binigay, ko-compute. Okay? So, next we have what we call the Cipolletti weir. Okay, pag Cipolletti weir, so ito 'yan, yung may theta tayo, no, kung nakikita niyo, no, yung theta natin ito sa baba. Ito, yung malapit dito sa L. That is yung ating 75.96 para masabi mo Cipolletti weir. Okay? Usually Cipolletti weirs are trapezoidal weirs with side slope 1 is to 4. So, ang side slope natin kapag Cipolletti weir ay 1 is to 4. Ayan, nakikita nyo. 1 horizontal, 4 vertical. Okay? The additional area at the sides adds approximately enough effective width of the stream to offset the side contraction. So, medyo mataas, no? Kasi yung angle niya ng alpha dito ay naka 14.4. So, papunta na ata tong rectangular. Pero dahil mayroon pang ano, putal na 15 or 14 point something degrees. So, yun. No? Yung alpha, kaya medyo papunta ng 90 degrees to, no? Kaya, yung formula natin for the actual discharge, that is 1.859 LH raised to 3 halves. And for English, 3.37 LH raised to 3 halves. Okay? Actual na yan, actual discharge na yan. So, yung C niyan, yung coefficient, so minultiply na dyan, and then, diretso na, no, with in relation to your length. Okay? And then next we have what we call the Sutro weir or what we call the proportional flow weirs. Okay? Sutro weir, proportional flow weirs. Okay? So, mukha siyang ano, may hyperbola, na meron tayong hyperbola or hyperbolic curve. Kaya yung ating actual discharge is 1 half C pi kasi meron tayong hyperbola eh. K multiplied by square root of 2gh. Yung ating K is 2x multiplied by square root of y. Okay? So, nag-vary yan, no? Depende sa inyong hyperbola. Okay? So, medyo saan itong ginagamit? Kung mga canals, no? Kapag usually, kapag yung liquid gusto mas mabilis yung flow kasi medyo mas liliit yung area. Okay? So, next, you have to call the submerged sharp weir. Okay? Pag submerged sharp weir, since sinubmerge natin yung ating weir, no, usually it is affected not only by the head on the upstream side, but by the head on the downstream. Kaya meron tayong in relation to H sub 1 tsaka H sub 2. Yan. Yung formula natin is, ng discharge, magagaling dito, the formula or the formula with respect to the submerged discharge. Okay, nakalagay dito, submerged discharge over the unsubmerged discharge is equal to 1 minus h sub 2 over h sub 1 raised to n. Tapos lahat ng yon naka-raise pa sa 0.385. 3 halves yung n kapag rectangular, 5 halves kapag triangular. Okay? So that is for the sharp or submerged sharp weir. Okay? And then yung last type natin ng weir is what we call the unsteady flow weirs. Okay? Sa unsteady flow weirs, yan, nakikita nyo, meron tayong formula na ito, no? Yung general formula natin. S A S D H over Q sub O. Di ba galing to do sa ating umpisa, no? Sa weirs. Ngayon, yun nga lang, meron tayong from H sub 2 to H sub 1 pinalita natin dahil anong ulit ang sinabi natin dito? Dahil magkakaroon ng negative sign. So, considering yung ating submerged weir, so mangyayari 2AS, no, napakita natin ito kanina, over C sub WL multiplied by 1 over square root of H sub 2 minus 1 over square root of H sub 1. Okay? So, ayan, no, galing dun sa formulas natin ng nung mga nauna. Okay? Where C sub W weir factor, L is the crest length, A sub S contact water surface area, H sub 1 is the initial head and H sub 2 is the final head. Okay? So, ito yung mga klase ng mga weirs.